Notice when Superman lands, the mother holds up a triangle with her hand over her forehead, holding up the back.
Now, wouldn't that beat all get out?
Well, you know,
Superman came down, the baby came down in a spaceship, starship, but what that really represents is the energy, the child coming through the womb of the portal, because as you know, when a comet comes down, a comet don't land as smooth as Superman landed. This baby landed smooth in the field. But what you're going to notice is, check this out. Look what the mother do. Notice how the mother gestured with the left hand. The left thumb is a sign that's used in those who are on the path of the left. Why would she gesture like this here for this baby? You see, she looking down in the earth. But in essence, the baby is not downward, right? It just shows you that the baby, Superman, spaceship, starship, slid across the field. But again, as you can see, her thumb, you'll find her doing this twice to represent the path for the left. That means witchcraft, sorcery, black magic, Satanism, and so forth and so on. Now look. The baby comes out of what looks like a womb of the vagina. Notice is gold on the inside and black on the outside, because that represents from darkness to light. The baby is not what we think is coming out of a spaceship, but represents the incarnation of a crystal ray. Is the reason why the crystals is around this Christ energy, this Christ child. And I explained to you that the baby name, Sky Smolensky, has sky in it. So we know that this baby came from the realms, the ethers, outer space, another planet. Now look, that is the opening of a vagina. You know how the walls, the clitoris. And notice how this baby, little Superman, is standing like the cross or in a T that represents argon energy, but nevertheless come down in a cross. But the cross, the T cross symbol sign, is an ancient sign. Now, we have the ability to zoom in. You will see what she held over the side of her face is a 3 and a 1. Don't take my word for it. Watch the movie. She holds a 3 on her right side of her cheek and a 1, which represent 13.
These years, as happy as we've been, how I've prayed and prayed the good Lord see fit to give us a child.
Honey, will you hand me that rag up there?
You take things easy now, Jonathan. Remember what Doc Fry said about that heart of yours.
Now, the first thing we got to do when we get home is find out who that boy's proper family is.
He hasn't got any. Not around here, anyway.
Now, this is very important. Now, what they didn't say was she called him Pa, P-A, and he calls her Ma. I'm going to see if I can go back to that. As they were driving on the road, she calls him Pa, and he calls her Ma, M-A. And his name, Pa, is P-A. When you put those words together, you get MAP. M-A-A-P, which says MAP. And it's mapping out something because it's explaining something and giving details to something. Now, her name is Martha. Martha is the name for an Eastern star. Okay, on the fourth points, you Google that on Google and you'll have that information. But I found that interesting that her name is Martha, which is the fourth point on the Eastern star. And Superman comes from the galactic, the Rams, as identifying with a fallen angel. Lucifer fell to the sky, it says, like in a ball of lightning or a lightning bolt is the reason why you see the lightning bolt is synonymous to Lucifer, fallen angel. Her name is Martha, which is a Eastern star. Her son and the father is wearing black and white of like in the Masonic checker floor. See, this movie gets deep and it's more than just what you think.
Martha, are you thinking what I think you're thinking?
We could say he's the child of my cousin in North Dakota and just now orphaned.
Oh, Martha.
Jonathan, he's only a baby.
Martha, now you saw how we found him.
Add that her hat is purple and women of the Eastern Star wear their hats. But Jonathan is also cold within himself. John means something, but I'm not going to get into that. And notice behind her that she represents the road, that path. Alright, let's carry on.
Martha, Clark, Kent, are you listening to what I'm saying?
Show you again, it shows you 13 again. Their truck, one of their wheels caught on flat, which represents one, and the three remaining tires has air in it. That's 13. Now mind you, they're both looking into the field. Now when you look into the field, you would notice that that slick mud path is connecting to the woman that represents the uterus. Look how slick and sleek it is, like the vagina. And if you look at it closely, it also resembles the phallus back where the ball is on each side, represents like the testicles. And the path is directing straight towards her, the woman. The mud represents melon, energy coming through that path. That path, male and female, they're looking back at the craft. You see? Because they know they came. This child came through her portal. keyed in on after they showed the baby Superman. It goes to the coach, because it all has its significance. At the time after they show the baby, he's wearing a black hat and a gray shirt. All that is code for something, for those that's in the know. And then he say, "Come on, gang."
That was a great game, huh?
Yes.
Look, there's three girls. Actually, there's four girls. Three white girls and one black girl. 13. Watch the movie. Don't take my word for it. Watch the movie. And the first two girls has on their shirt that's jumping over the green is SS. SS is also known for secret society. And we're not talking about the SS Hitler. These two girls jumps over the green to where you'll find Superman is. Because these members of the highest order, or these societies that keeps the secret, is aware of this child. You see the H next to the SS, which represents the 8. As you remember, the father, Jor-El, had the 8 Saturn circle spinning in a circle. The field, you'll see where the ball is kicked or put over, the 8 represents something. Pay attention, because you're going to see them showing the sign of 31 again, which is 13. Two Caucasian girls with the SS on their shirt jumping over the green. And then you will see them show from 2, which is going to be 23. Two white girls, the SS. Then it's going to show 3 white girls and 1 black girl. So 2, 3, and 1, which is really 23, that identify to who this person is, the one which shows the 13. See? The hand gesture the mother made in the truck with her right arm forming a triangle. Go back and see.
Goal of self-deification. For someone who follows a left-hand path, the main goal is to become a god, be the creator of their own universe. This is an element found across tantric traditions and endorsed by left-hand occultists in the West as well. In this sense, even when a practitioner works with a deity, a demon or a spirit, is not a worship in a monotheistic sense, but a relationship established with the aim of a progressive self-ascension. In some cases...
Now you see it. What is the left-hand path? I wanted to show you, for those who are not familiar, that you will see that the mother, when she was in the vehicle, the mother... Go down to the bottom. You notice that the mother had her left thumb sticking up. When she looked down at Superman, she did it twice to identify with what this witch occultist just said. It represents the path to being God or God. And she acknowledging that her son is a God. Look far at the bottom, it says more about the left-hand path and ritual magic. To show you, I'm not making this up. Now notice here that the women, the cheerleaders, they're going to run towards Superman because they're going to give the mathematical sign, the seal, encoded in math and numbers of who Superman is. But notice that they break off into 13. It's 3 girls on the right hand side and there's 1 on the left hand side. And the goal is in the sign of an H, as I showed you and I explained to you. and you will see the formation of the 13 come together. And this is important because what's going to be revealed is a, can't give it away. Let's watch the movie.
That was a great game, huh?
Yeah.
Look, they show the math of 52. 52 means something because 52 is really 25, and 25 is 7. And that means something because we're talking about somebody who is to come, who Superman really is. Now, back up a little so that you can see more clearly. Look, what you see is the two girls, the SS, the white represent luminosity. They're going to jump. You see the black girl in the middle, but you're going to find out that there's four girls, right? Check this out. It's four girls all together, and one being black.
Come on.
That's four. Remember I showed you in video 2, explaining the Superman mysteries, I told you and showed you the number 4 and 7, which happened to be the year of someone who was born. They just showed it in the math of the four cheerleaders. And next to the four cheerleaders is 52. And 52 is 7. So what it just said, 47 is 74, which is the year of this Christ-type super person, is the year of, as I showed you, 1974, which is encoded here. Attention. Now you see, the coat also sound like the coat. Next to the coach is 5, which is the number for a star, which happened to be 5. Now watch this. You will see as the coach walk away, you will see over his head is like a pyramid-like. Okay? This coat, which represents coat, is going to say, come on gang, what is a gang? A gang represents a group, right? Alright.
Come on gang!
Check this out. Notice that Superman in the red is right between the gold. And you also notice that was brought to my attention that the cheerleaders, when they come running, you're going to notice that there's going to be a black pole that happened to represent the phallus in between the gold. The answer just brought that to my attention. Watch this.
That was a great game, huh?
Yeah.
Just so you can see it. Let's back it up some so you can see that. As they run from the field.
Huh? Yeah.
You see? As they run from the field, you'll see right where they get ready to jump. That black pole thing represents the phallus in between the goal. You see, all this is code talk, but remember that I told you that the story of Isis and Osiris, she transformed into a bird and she flew on top of Osiris' phallus. All this is code talk. I'm not going to get too deep off into it, but the signs are here. Now mind you, the answers brought something to my attention. You have four girls here. 5 and 2 equals 7. That's 47. Okay? And everything is moving from right to left. And what you're going to see is going to say 1974. Look. The white on the far right hand side represents 1. The 72 7 plus 2 represents 9. Alright? And 52 represents 7. And the girls in front represents 4. I can't make this up. It just said 1974 with Superman in the middle. See? 52. And then 72. And then the one. The illuminated one. The illuminated one. Which is 1. 7 plus 2 is 9. And 52 is 7. And the 4 girls, it just said 1974. And then you have the coded number of, look, 5 and 8 is 13. And 5 behind 5 plus 8 is 13. And 5 and a 0 is a cipher, so we just said 13-5.
Remember about those uniforms, cleaned and washed by tomorrow, and looking like a football team.
Hey, Clark, let's have all those clothes washed and ready for tomorrow's game,
yes,
okay?
Sir. Got to be Mount Vernon High!
Can you give me a list?
No, home early!
Lana, don't bother with these, huh?
All right. Notice you'll see Clark Kent next to, which is Christopher Reeves. Well, I explained to you what Christopher means. On the right-hand side is the color lavender, the truck.
Come in with the other equipment.
Thank you, Clark.
Sure.
Listen, a whole bunch of us are going up to Mary Ellen's, play some records. Would you like to come?
Sure. Sounds like it'd be a lot of fun.
There go that H again.
And can't make it.
You see. And then on the right-hand side is the color lavender, which is a royal color.
Got a lot of work to do.
What are you talking about? I just finished stacking all...
All that?
Oh.
I'm sorry, I said lavender. I mean turquoise. Not lavender. Lavender is purple. But turquoise, you will notice the turquoise truck. The answers to say turquoise.
Brad.
Hey, come on, Lana.
Come on, Lana. Come on, let's go. Come on, he's gotta clean this up.
Now, let me explain something to you. Let me enlighten you on something. This is dealing with the third eye. And this is important that I tell this to you and explain this to you so that you can understand what I'm about to bring to your attention and enlighten you on. You'll be amazed and even many perplexed. But it states here, this is a depiction of an old theory about how the pineal gland relates to our eyes and vision. The lines represent our physical range of focus. Don't you notice a stunning resemblance to a very familiar symbol, the sigil of Lucifer? It is also very interesting that the pineal gland rests in between the two lines that tip the lower V shape. There is obviously more to this symbol than meets the eye. This is the shape and how the V connects to the back side of the brain. And it connects. The symbolism is also the 3 points, is also the 3 points that shows in Krypton, where it shows 3 points of 3 on the left and 2 on the right. It says here, the sigil of Lucifer sign, the symbol for the spiritual enlightenment. Lucifer means literally light bearer. And this represents, it's supposed to be the seal of Lucifer. And it's important because we're talking about the Philosopher's Stone. It's the reason why I bring this up. Stay tuned for part 4 on the mysteries of Superman. It's going to get deep.